Every last one of these black homies I want to be saved. Because they know where we come from. I remember one time, it probably wasn't even no this many black police out here, man.
They just worse. Some of them just even worse.
Black police just as worse as the white ones. It's not a black and white thing. It's a police and a citizen thing. Because they supposed to be citizens, but they ain't citizens. They super citizens. They got a badge in the
gun. Name?
John.
John, why are you here and why are you wearing an I Can't Breathe t-shirt?
Well, I'm here because I work at a treatment center about a mile from here. And we'd be a lot better off if we were doing more in treatment,
exactly.
Sending fewer people to jail.
Right.
And I think it's,
I'm sure we'll all
terrible that this man died, and so have a lot of others, including Eric Garner.
Do you think it has anything to do with the fact that there's so much profit in prisons?
And that, well, there's a lot of profit in prisons, there's a lot of profit in drugs, there's a lot of profit in a lot of things that aren't working.
Yeah. Right, so people are profiting, they're not really looking to solve problems. Maybe that's like the problem.
Well, a lot of people are. Yeah, there's a lot of truth to that. There's certainly a large system that's working against the interests of a lot of people that live around here. There's no question about that.
Cop in this whole shitty ass department, and he was basically getting awarded. He got promoted really fast. He was out on a thing one day and he saw these guys beat up somebody and he reported it like he should be, and immediately he got ostracized, blackballed by the entire police department, and they started threatening his life. They left dead animals on his car, dead rats on his car.
Who did?
I can't remember his name, but you could easily retrieve it on the internet.
No, who was leaving the dead animals on his car?
Dead animals, his own officers. His officers, they all blackballed this guy.
So he was...
Not all cops are bad, but the ones that aren't get driven out by them.
Jamaican, yo.
Oh, yeah. I'm
the big black ugly motherfucker.
Yeah, he always beat
I'm
motherfuckers
I'm going to put him on
up.
Facebook.
That's another short. He got right there.
You ain't going
to
be dead.
Got the sergeant straight on. A little short, but he'll another one. Beat the shit out of
him.
Right there.
Black as we are.
Right there. I'm right there.
Walking this way.
Yeah, he a murderer. He's the murderer, and he's the murderer.
Do that. Go back over there.
Yeah, they murdered him.
Who did you see the murder?
They beat people up all the time. He beat me up several times.
Who else you say?
Him and the short. Where the short?
They're gonna see you.
The one right there.
You just have to look at him.
You got
an answer to the job.
You think it's a game? I'm not playing.
You're
Just please say and spell your name for the camera.
Larry King.
How do you spell your last name?
G-A-I-N-E-S.
Great. And you're from Baltimore?
Yes, sir.
Your whole life?
All my life. Born and raised.
Great. And could you talk about the leadership in Baltimore today and how they're kind of dealing with this crisis?
I think they're doing a whitewash way. Just say this. We had a young lady, a 3-year-old child was killed. Vance made the same statement that he made yesterday. We have 30 investigators. We're going to have the person within a week. And they locked up a man for 3 months. Nothing happened. Right? They came out yesterday only because the ministers asked for his resignation. We're going into election season, and now they're shaking, right? So I'm imagining man saying, you better get out there and save my ass, because this election season, everything they say is going to be held against them. So they came out, and all they did was give us an update of everything that we already know. We got the same thing. We got the 30 investigators. Only thing we didn't know is it was somebody else with a camera. What he should have said to the person, go to the lawyer, go to Billy Murphy, go to the media. If you have that, that way you feel safe. Baltimore, we don't have a good relationship with the police. They whip our ass every day. They lock us up for nothing. If you ride through the seat, you'll see them when they grab you. They make you sit on the curb. They violate your rights every day. So they say, now, we want you to help us? Come on.